My name is Professor Chris Day. I'm the Vice Chancellor and President of Newcastle University. EDI is really important to me for a number of reasons. Perhaps the most obvious one is that I believe we will be a better organisation if we follow EDI principles. I think for the students that we educate, I think they need to be educated in an EDI-friendly environment, but perhaps more importantly, by educating them along EDI principles, when they go out into the world, we will have a better society with graduates who have been educated like this. The fourth reason is just a sort of real concern that somewhere in our organisation, a member of staff, perhaps even a student, is not being given the opportunity to fulfil their potential. The four guiding principles that underpin all of our strategies fill this agenda extremely well.
Hi, I'm Julie Sanders and I'm Deputy Vice-Chancellor here at Newcastle University. I think it's been really important for Newcastle Athena SWAN, but I think we're at a really interesting moment. Lots of research, lots of thinking in all of our different teams about intersectionality. So I think that broader equality, diversity, inclusion agenda, really key. I think starting things like the Race Equality Charter work this year, none of that would have happened without that first stage work around Athena SWAN. But it's taking us to that, I suppose, more holistic view of all of our experiences, staff and students. And for me, part of that is also thinking about the different kinds of career experiences that we all have, the different rhythms of an academic career and how we can start to recognise that, the different rhythms of a working week, how we can start to get light and air into people's lives, sort of rethink, reset the dial in some way on some of the things we're doing to get the culture change we need to allow for flexible working, for different kinds of patterns, different kinds of opportunities. Everybody being able to bring the best of themselves to the table is how I like to express it.
Hi, my name's Judith Rankin and I'm the Dean of Equality, Diversity and Inclusion for Newcastle University. We recognise the importance of establishing a culture where everyone can feel welcome and where everyone is valued. We have a well-established women's network, NU Women, but over recent months we've been establishing other staff networks. We have a BAME network, a disability interest group, our Rainbow at Newcastle staff network, and we will be establishing an NU carers group.
I'm Kelechi Dibi and I'm the Equality and Diversity and Inclusion Officer for HAS. Our first ever comprehensive carer survey, which was launched in February of 2019 and lasted 6 weeks. We did the same for students as well. So from this survey, we've ended up acquiring a rich data of carers. It's important that, you know, that we support this project because it's potluck. Anybody can be a carer at any time without warning.
Hello, my name is Dave Watt. I'm Head of Strategic Projects and I work in the Estate Support Service at Newcastle University. We're making the campus more inclusive in a number of ways. We also look at getting the viewpoints of disabled people across the campus, what makes their lives difficult, and we build that into our access improvement plan. The campus, we're trying to make more child-friendly at the moment. What we're trying to do is look at how we can make more nursing rooms available, more baby change rooms available.
My name's Jennifer Monkley and I'm a prostate cancer researcher in the Institute of Genetic Medicine. So I benefited from the Returners Programme after I returned from maternity leave last year. I got support to help me go to a conference with my daughter because I was breastfeeding at the time and so I wasn't able to leave her. And at the time I'd felt I'd already missed so much from being off and the field was moving so quickly. It was so important for me to go and it wouldn't have been possible without getting the support from the university.
So my name's Paul Fleet. I'm a senior lecturer in the School of Arts and Cultures. In 2017, I set up a survey for the School of Arts and Cultures and asked all of our staff, how do you feel email's working for you and would you value some guidance on this? I came up with a set of five principles, the A, B, C, D and E of email usage. A is for annual leave and part-time work. We must respect those times when we're not in work. B is for brevity, making sure that the email's concise. C, carbon copy. Who are you sending this to? Who really does need to see this? D, to define your subject line, to make it easier to find. And E was about email itself, breaking it down into three distinct areas, not a single activity. So in terms of EDI and in terms of well-being of our staff and our students, I have received both anecdotally and in emails messages saying, this has transformed my work. It's given me the permission that I needed to be able to maintain a healthy work-life balance.